got the K70 RGB rapid fire keyboard. I got a desktop internal hard drive, 1 terabyte. That's gonna be for storing videos, archiving, and sound banks. Got the EVGA SuperClock GeForce GTX 1070. The case gonna be a Cooler Master Master Case Profile module. Main hard drive is going to be the Samsung 950 Pro M.2. The engine, CPU is going to be my i7-6850K. It's just a thumb drive, 64 gig thumb drive. My motherboard is gonna be the Strix X99 gaming motherboard. To cool it off, I went with an air cooler. I got the Master Air Maker 8. Reason I ain't going with water cooler, I might not use this system in a while. I might come back to it, and I don't know what it's gonna do sitting in storage. It might leak, might don't leak, temperature change. I don't have choice. If it was something I was gonna use constantly every day, I could keep my eye on it, I probably would have went water cooling. But this way I don't have to like come home to no surprise. Memory, I got the Vengeance of LPX. It's a 16 gig box, two gigs a piece, 32 and all. For my power, we got the VGA Gold 750. Put this thing together. Yeah, so what I think, computer's fast, it's snappy, it's responsive, it's reliable. I'm gonna show you a couple features on here. This icon right here, I can control the fan speed. You can hear it wind up. So that's turbo. That's silent mode. I got a couple apps already open. I got Sony. Got ZBrush. Oh, this is Grave right here. This is Oracle Virtual Machines. Now with this, you can't go wrong. You can use this like a second operating system. Well, you can choose any operating system you want. But good thing about this, you ain't gotta worry about no virus. You can go online with this. You can run tests. You can just mess around. Experiment and see how fast it loads up. It's already loaded up. Let's see, that's a second Windows 10 within inside of a Windows 10. And I got too many apps open. I usually just pop on. Or I might be doing an update. I got two Windows 10 running at the same time. And y'all can do everything that the main one can do. I just will eventually run out of memory on the second one, but that's about it. This is an expensive system. Would I do it again? No. I probably would opt for a faster process. I probably went with the i7 7700K. I think it's a 4.2 processor. This one's a 3.8. You got more cores, but really I don't need more cores. I come to find out, I thought I was gonna do 3D graphics. Well, I did a little 3D graphics, but you know, I'm doing a lot more video editing than 3D artwork. So I could have done that. Where it's here, so I'll make the best of it. That's about it. I'm gonna show how fast this computer loads up. The only reason it's a little slow, it's not slow, it's a built-in delay. And the delay is there for, so if you did have an issue, you can catch a BIOS. Cause it loads up so fast, you won't be able to hit alt delete or whatever you get into your BIOS, you won't be able to do it. So you gotta put that pre-delay in there. And the only reason why I had all those apps open, so it's properly shutting them down. But now it's coming on. That's the pre-delay. It would have been on by now, like I said. Give him the chance to catch the BIOS if you wanted to get up in the BIOS. But yeah, it just popped on. That's it. It's fast. on the shelf as it come on. I mean, boot up. Everything just come on, pop on. That's the wall. My mom. You call it kind of wallpaper this is. Wallpaper engine. You can get that from the Steam store. That moving wallpaper. But it's all loaded up now. Fresh that color features on this shortcut control. It's actually, you can change the speed from here. Your performance, how much power you want to use. Well, I'm changing it. Turbo coil. Oh yeah. This right here, you can sign like, so I got Vega open right now. If you look down here, it's a Turbo Core app. It's on Core 5, and Core 5 is running at 42 hertz. I'll show you all my cores. And this one app using that Core 5, so that's pretty cool. You can actually customize each core on its own. Each core, there's a core one, it start with zero. That's running at 41. You can go right here and change the ratio to down to 40. But that's it on that. So you don't even have to go to the BIOS. You can do everything from your desktop.